back now, and I'm trying to think how long it's been, but I can't even think the amount of years, but it's been years. From as far as I can think back, she had that oxygen tank and was walking around with that oxygen in her nose and all that. And on that Friday was the first time in years I did not see her with that oxygen tank in her nose. And it just brought about a liveliness and a newness about her, even in her death. And so that was the first time I seen her. And I just thank God and I praise God for seeing her in that predicament, knowing that she wasn't suffering no more pain, you know, no more sickness, and not having to walk around with that junk in her nose. Amen. She looked like a newborn baby. Amen. I mean, it just was a glow and a newness about her, even in the midst of that. And I thank God for that, because that gave me a peace. Amen. Even in the midst of that situation, of being able to see that. And so God got a funny way of doing stuff. You know, God got a funny way of being able to encourage you and console you in the most unorthodox ways. Amen. In the name of the Lord. And if you let God be your comforter, He'll comfort you.
Amen.
Amen. If you let God be God, He'll find a way to do it. Amen. And He'll do it in ways that are unimaginable. Amen. And so I give God glory, honor, and praise just for the simple things. You know, I ain't got to sit here and thank God about big stuff. I can praise God for little stuff. Amen. That's the little things God does. Amen. Just blows my mind. Amen. In the name of the Lord. Psalms 124. Amen. Psalms 124. If it had not been the Lord, in verse number 1. Psalms 124, and verse number 1. And the word of the Lord said, and I want y'all to listen to these words and dissect them and digest them. Amen. As we read this tonight. And the word of the Lord said what? If it had not been the Lord, the writer pins the words and says, if it had not been the Lord, who was on our side, now may Israel say, if it had not been the Lord, who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they had swallowed us up quick. Amen. When their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters had overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. Then the proud waters. Had gone over our soul.
Blessed be the Lord.
Who has not given us as a prey
to their teeth.
Our soul is escaped.
As a bird out of the snare of the fowlers. The snare is broken. And we are escaped.
Our help
is in the name of the Lord.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Made heaven and earth.
If it had not been,
yes, Lord,
for the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, we would have been swallowed up quickly. We would have been consumed. But thanks be to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
That the Lord was on our side.
Amen.
And I don't know about you, but I can think of quite a few situations I've been in.
Yes.
And I can say, just like David, yes, if it had not been, glory to God. Amen. If it had not been,
thank you, Lord,
for the Lord on our side,
thank
I would have been
Jesus.
Messed up.
Yeah.
I would have been jacked up.
Yes.
I probably would have been cracked up.
Yeah.
Toped up.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen.
So stuff in life can throw you overboard.
Yes.
Amen. The enemy will throw things in your life that can make a mess of you if you let it.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
But when you realize that God is on your side, I can dance off this right now.
That's right.
Amen. Yeah. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and everything that he's done. Yeah, not just some of the stuff. I think about everything that he's done. Amen. It's some stuff that I could have been thrown overboard by. There's some people that if they had their way, I would not be here.
That's right.
Praise the name of the Lord. If they had their way, I would have fallen and been consumed a long time ago. But I thank God that if he had not been there, I would have been destroyed. But David looks at the situation and he says that if he was not there, we would have been swallowed up quickly. Their wrath would have been kindled against us. We would have been overwhelmed. Praise the name of the Lord. We would have been overcome. The proud waters would have gone over our soul. He said, but blessed be the Lord who has not given us as a prey to their teeth. And our soul is escaped as a bird out of the snare of the fowler.
Amen.
The snare is broken. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When you think of a snare is something to entrap a bird.
Right.
Praise the name of the Lord. Something that was to confine you, to imprison you, to bring you into bondage.
That's right.
But the writer said the snare is broken.
Thank you, Lord.
We get out of here. The snare is broken. In other words, whatever the enemy tried to use to bring you into captivity, whatever he uses to try to bring you into prison, whatever he uses to try to bind you up, God said it is broken. And you are escaped. But this is the thing that David realized, Sister Jewelry. He realized that he didn't break it on his own. He knew that he couldn't have done it by himself. He knew that it took somebody bigger and better than him to be able to bring him out of that and cause him to escape. So in the last verse, he said, our help is in the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. So tonight I'm telling the church, if you don't know where your help is, it's in the name of the Lord. So the next time you're going through whatever you're going through and the devil trying to bombard your mind, trap your spirit, you better call on the name of the Lord. And what's his name? Somebody ought to shout it from the depths of your soul. Jesus. You ought to shout it because the help is in the name of the Lord. When you're going through trouble, you ought to call Jesus. When your body's racking with pain, you ought to shout Jesus. Hallelujah. When your house is in disarray and your mind is in confusion, you ought to call Jesus. Because our help, I wish somebody would help me here. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Can I tell y'all something, saints? The government is not our help. Praise the name of the Lord. Congress is not our help. Can I tell y'all, the President of the United States of America is not our help, but our help is in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You can run wherever you want to run, but at the end of the day, you got to come back to a name, and that name is J-E-S-U-S. Hallelujah. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous have their too. And they are safe. There's safety in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. There's help in the name of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Amen. I don't care what you're going through. I don't care what the situation is. I don't care what the doctor report is. I don't care what nobody said. You better believe the report of the Lord. Let me tell you something. You ain't got to run to no psychologist. You ain't got to run from one doctor to another doctor. You ain't got to go get on drugs and drink. All you got to do is call on the name of the Lord. And when you call on the name of the Lord, out of a sincere heart, he will be your help.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. innocent. And when you call on them, they come to your rescue. But can I tell you something? We got something better than Geico Insurance. We got something better than AAA. We got a name that's above every name. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.